Hey guys, welcome to Electrofund. In my previous video, I have started with microwave and radar engineering, tube devices. So I have covered why we need to use tube devices for high frequencies, which is microwave frequencies, because active devices are not suitable for microwave frequencies. Because of its reasons, I have covered disadvantages of that in my previous video. So two cavity klystron, which I covered in my previous video, is an amplification device which is for amplification of microwave frequencies. This device, which is reflex klystron, it is used for oscillations. So what I will cover in this video is highlights are I will cover specifications, the working principle or operation, the Applegate graph and the applications. So let's get started. Now, as we know, the principle of oscillation, it is a self-generating frequency in a particular device. So in the same case, let's start with the construction explanation of reflex klystron. We have a repeller space, we have a RF output cavity, we have a heater and repeller, which both are negatively charged, and anode wire. So first what we do is we provide high reverse bias voltage to cathode and repeller under heater conditions to form electron beam. So these are the initial conditions we provide with high voltage, high repeller or high reverse bias voltage. Okay. Now in the case of two cavity klystron, what we did was we have an RF input. We provided a input in an input cavity and then it undergoes velocity modulation process. But in this case we cannot give any input. So what we need to assume is we need to assume this RF output cavity has some noise. Now what happens if we don't assume that there is no noise? So this is not possible because oscillation principle works on that only. So we need to have small noise or some amount of noise. Let's just say this is our noise, a wave. Okay. So for positive cycle, electron beam is accelerated because this is repeller. So positive negative. So it will try to attract the repeller. So for positive cycle, it will accelerate and it will travel higher distance, or you can say more distance, because it is positively charged and this is my negatively charged. So it will try to attract and travel more distance in my repeller space. Then repeller will send back the electron beam to RF or output cavity. So for positive cycle, when the beam is traveling towards repeller, it sends back the signal to RF or output cavity. For no noise condition, it will travel with the average speed and it will cover average distance in repeller space. And for negatively charged, as it is already negative, the repeller is also under negatively charged ions, so it will repel and it will travel less space or less distance, it will cover less distance in my repeller space. So using the Applegate graph, we can explain for positive cycle, it will travel higher distance and come back to output cavity. For no noise condition, it will travel average distance and with an average speed and come to output cavity. And for negative, it travels less distance and comes to output cavity. Now there are, for a one noise signal, there are three different kinds of electrons traveling with three different speeds. So at a particular point, they meet at RF or output cavity. Because the average speed becomes equal, it is designed in such a way that the average speed becomes equal at output cavity. Now this electron bunch, which is formed using the first noise input which we considered, it is formed at output cavity and it results for the next signal which will move forward. I mean to say is that as it is oscillation, so it will keep on oscillating. So this electron bunch will result into the next signal for the same operation. So it will go on repeating. So at this point, the depth of modulation is small because the RF or noise we considered was small. So as this process continues, the depth of modulation increases and it results in increase of frequency as well. So the oscillations of frequency is decided by the overall dimension, or you can say 360 degree phase shift, and it can also be adjusted by varying the repeller voltage, because it all depends on repeller voltage and the strength of the signal. This process continues and the oscillation is generated for microwave frequency. So the specifications are covered, the working diagram, working and working principle is also covered. The Applegate diagram is this, and what are the applications? It is used in radar reception. It is also used as local and pump oscillator. It is also used as a microwave source, or you can say portable links. So these are some of the applications of reflex klystron. I hope you have understood the topic. If you have any doubts, you can comment and ask me. Till then, like my video, share it with your friends and subscribe my channel. Thank you.